One of the stranger episodes during the Apollo missions involved the astronauts seeing bizarre flashes of light within their spacecraft that to this day are not well understood. Called the cosmic ray visual phenomena, or LF for light flashes, these illustrate perhaps more dramatically than most ways that we evolved on Earth, and in space our bodies don't always behave like they would on the ground. The phenomenon is not limited to Apollo. It was just noted most prominently among the astronauts on that mission, but it's also been associated with the ISS, Mir, and the missions to the Hubble Space Telescope and others. They are almost universally reported as being white flashes that curiously clustered around the time the astronauts were getting ready to sleep. One notable exception was one astronaut that reported a flash as being blue instead of white, which may be telling as to its cause. The shapes of the flashes the astronauts saw varied wildly, though most were reported as spots, streaks, or comets. At times, they were directional. One astronaut was so bothered by the flashes, all moving in the same direction, which were present whether his eyes were open or closed, that to sleep he had to shield himself behind a wall of lead-containing batteries to get any sleep during a solar storm, and even then, it didn't completely work. This suggests that this phenomenon is different from what is known as a phosphene, the perception of light that isn't really there. That can have many causes, but it's always internal to the body. But for the astronauts, however, an external source seems to be more likely, and research points to high-energy particles being the culprit. Nailing down the exact circumstances of that, however, has proven difficult, but one possibility is that when high-energy cosmic rays pass through the liquid in the eye, they produce a tiny flash of Cherenkov radiation. Cherenkov radiation is interesting. It's produced when a charged particle exceeds the speed of light. I know, nothing can exceed the speed of light, but that's not entirely true. What is true is that nothing can exceed the speed of light in a vacuum, but in a medium, such as water in the astronaut's eye, the speed of light is much slower and can be exceeded. This is most notably seen in nuclear reactors, which glow blue with Cherenkov radiation. That single astronaut also saw blue light, so perhaps it was Cherenkov light that he saw. Experiments done on Earth, however, suggest otherwise, but there are other possible mechanisms for the flashes. It's possible that charged particles are directly interacting with the optic nerve or even the visual centers of the brain itself, or it could be due to a mixed bag of causes. One thing that was noted with Apollo was that upon leaving the full protection of the Earth's magnetosphere, the phenomenon got much worse, with the astronauts reporting incidents once every few minutes on their way to the moon. Curiously enough, though, the astronauts saw them more frequently when they were actively looking for them, suggesting that they are something that can, at least sometimes, be tuned out by the brain on long space missions. Hopefully, tuning out is a viable way to mitigate the flashes, as they will no doubt be ever-present during any future missions to Mars and beyond, and it might also be something that can be shielded against. But this isn't the only case where radiation of some sort affected human senses in an unusual way. During World War II, people walking near radar transponders reported hearing the radar. The cause is thought to be expansion in the inner ear when exposed to microwaves, but it really goes to show that we aren't really designed to tolerate much other than the visual spectrum as far as various forms of radiation are concerned. But curiously, there are a handful of organisms on this Earth that can handle ridiculous amounts of radiation, so much so that they may be able to survive exposure to space with no ill effects, and may have even spent part of their evolutionary history off-world, but I'll save that for another video. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently responding to critics of the antimatter jelly donut. Yes, I know antimatter would better be used to power spacecraft or blow up Jupiter, but that wouldn't be as delicious, and be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.